Welcome to Sibia Medical Center's YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Kirit Sibia, consultant pulmonologist at Sibia Medical Center, and today I'm going to be talking about how to take your temperature reading correctly. Anyone who has COVID or even in general times needs to keep a thermometer at their home. I recommend that you use a digital thermometer and do not use the old age mercury thermometer, especially in people who are elderly, who could bite onto it if they have poor sensorium or an altered state of mind, and if mercury goes inside, it can be very dangerous. So let's talk about using a digital thermometer. A digital thermometer is your go-to choice, and if you have COVID, you must check your temperature 3 times a day and note it down so that you can talk about it with your doctor. You would simply have to press the button and turn it on. Once you do that, it will show a reading. Do not immediately put the thermometer in your mouth or your armpit. You need to wait to get a reading that says LO low. Once you get this reading on your thermometer, it means now you can put your thermometer in the mouth, under the tongue, and close your mouth. Not be breathing through the mouth during that period. Can breathe through the nose. Keep it for 1 minute. And if you keep it in your armpit, again keep it for 1 minute. But in the digital thermometers, they start beeping at 1 minute. They will start going beep beep, and that's when you know that the reading has been attained, and you take the thermometer out and you note down the reading. The thermometer temperature reading that it takes in the mouth is the core body temperature, which means if you take a thermometer reading from the oral cavity or the mouth and it gives you a reading of say 99 degrees Fahrenheit, then the body temperature is 99 degrees Fahrenheit. But if you put this in the armpit and then you take a temperature and it is showing you a temperature of 99 degrees Fahrenheit, you have to add 1 degree to that to get the core body temperature. So the temperature would actually be 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So chart this accordingly and then let your doctor know so that he can understand how your disease is progressing or subduing, and then plan the best management protocol for you. Thank you for watching. I wish you all good health.